Hey, good morning. Welcome to Blue Collar Fishing. It's about mid-March. I've actually got some pretty weather and I have seen some fish swim today, so we're going to see if we can do maybe catch a couple of panfish. A buddy of mine said he needed a crash course in how to use this, the trout magnet. And I can't fish for trout with it right now due to the lockout. Trout doesn't open for two more weeks, but I can. Sometimes it will catch panfish. I mean, same company also makes a crappie rig. So, that's what I'm gonna try to do today. I'm gonna put one of these small jigs on. See if we get a couple of bluegill to bite on it, baby. This is the pollen. Speaking of, man, the mask mandates have been lifted here. Let's go see all y'all's faces again. Forgot what everybody looked like. Let's go see what we can do.
Grant, sometimes it works.
Okay, so what the trout magnet is really, it's just a small jig. One just fell out, so we'll use that one. So yeah, the trout magnet's a small jig. It's a 1/64 ounce jig. Different variety of trailers that you can put on them. The two I have the most success with are white and pink for some reason. I don't know what it is about pink. The trout seem to really enjoy pink. So I don't know what it looks like in the water to them. So we're going to put a little. Now I can't fish for trout today. If you're in Pennsylvania, you understand that I can't fish for trout until the rest of y'all can fish for trout. We're in the lockout. Trout opens in 2 weeks on April 2nd. So unless you're in a delayed harvest area, and I'm not. But trout can often be used to the same tactics as panfish, or panfish can be use the same tactics as trout. So there are a couple of different ways to fish the trout magnet. What you do is you want to take your trailer. You're using the trailer that comes with the trout magnet. You can see the tail is split here, right? There's a cavity and a hole that goes down the center of that. I'm gonna rig that. That down that cavity till it comes out back right in the split of that tail. Now, if you get it, if you do like me and you mess up the guide and just start over, plastic's pretty durable on these. So what I'll do is to line it up is I'll take the eye of the jig here. And I'll make sure that the eye of the jig, twist this little trailer until the eye of the jig can set in that slit. So now I know that's lined up with the tip of my hook. Straightened out. So got some cut off plastic on it. We'll go ahead and get rid of that. Now the line I use in the gear, or the line anyway, that I'm going to use is going to be, you kind of see it there. Now this is Berkeley Trilene 4-pound monofilament, low visibility green. I use green because water's actually green if you look at it. It's tied a little polymer knot, a strong knot. And now there's couple of different ways you can fish this. We've got the shad dart head, and that's what the trout magnet is called. It's called a shad dart head. So it's a shad dart head jig. Now you can fish this just like this, with just this. Give it some wiggle sometimes, make it do that in the water. Or you can just lift it up, let it fall back down in the strike zone. Leland also has in their trout magnet box these small quartz peg. It's got a line right here. You can just put your line through it. You ain't got to take your hook off or anything. So you put your line through it. Once you get the line through, you can peg it at whatever level you want it to be. If you're an older guy and you've been around for a while, you probably recognize that this technique is what was called before, just in a lot smaller version, the floating fly. All right, so cast out. That was terrible. Might want to release the Bauhausen, Kelly. All right, so we're going to cast out there, all right? Now, it's only a 1/64 of an ounce, so you're going to need some lighter tackle to cast it. An ultralight rod works really well. This is an IM7. That's what I use. Got a hit right there. You see, I'm giving that rod tip just a little bit of bounce. So a little bit of bounce. Make it, give it some shimmy. That's how I fish it. Take one of your corks here, and a peg. It's got one in it. So take one of your corks here and a peg. We're in a pond, so it's a little bit deeper. If you're in a stream, you know, adjust how far up you want that cork to where it doesn't get hung on the bottom. If you're using this floating fly in running water, what you want to do is you want to adjust the cork to a height where it just keeps it up off the bottom. You can tell if it's up too far, you keep seeing your cork go down, and when you pull on it, there ain't no fish. So if your cork's going down but there's no fish on it, then you've got your cork up a little bit too high. Just adjust it to make the lead shorter from the cork to your jig.
Another tip for making this more effective is being able to fish somewhere there's trout. This does work a lot better for trout than stock trout than anything else.